The Apollo-Soyuz test project was a joint space mission between the United States and the Soviet Union in July of 1975, marking an end to the space race between the two Cold War rivals. The diplomacy, techniques, and technology developed for ASTP helped open the gates for future cooperation after the space race. The space race was born from pre-existing tensions between the United States and the Soviet Union after World War II. This period of tension was known as the Cold War. The Russian launch of the world's first artificial satellite, Sputnik, in 1957, prompted the United States to take action, consolidating their space programs into NASA a year later. This is considered the beginning of the space race.
We have been given the scientific knowledge, the technical ability, and the materials to pursue the exploration of the universe. To ignore these great resources would be a corruption of a God-given ability.
The space race was full of the US and the USSR battling for firsts in spaceflight achievement. First satellite, first human in orbit, and first man on the moon would all be titles fought for. The public viewed these achievements as technological superiority over the other country. This climate of space rivalry left little room for collaboration. The US had made attempts to reach cooperation with its opposing power throughout the 60s, but had little success, though this was mostly due to political issues rather than technical ones.
In the field of space, there is room for new cooperation, for further joint efforts in the regulation and exploration of space. I include among these possibilities a joint expedition to the moon.
In 1969, the United States landed Apollo 11 on the surface of the moon, with the Soviets never matching such an achievement. This, along with a relaxation of tensions, was a turning point in cooperation. With little hope in catching back up with the US, the Soviets could now use cooperation to portray a depiction of parity with its former rival. Both sides were also interested in using space as a new front for Cold War détente. Using space as diplomatic propaganda. In April 1970, NASA Administrator Thomas O. Paine and Russian diplomat Anatoly Blagonrivov had an informal dinner meeting in New York. It was at this meeting that the idea of an international docking was first brought up. In October that same year, representatives from both countries' space programs met in Moscow. They studied joint docking and agreed on holding future meetings. One early concept studied was docking a spacecraft to a Soviet Salyut space station, or America's planned Skylab. These ideas eventually fell through, though, because of their technical and economic issues. Instead, they favored the docking of an American Apollo module and a Soviet Soyuz spacecraft. During the Strategic Arms Limitation Talks in May 1972, the Exploration and Use of Outer Space for Peaceful Purposes Agreement was signed. This document, signed by leaders of both nations, formally validated an international mission, with the ASTP name first mentioned a month later. Even before an official agreement was signed, American and Soviet engineers were debating on how to dock the two spacecraft together. They eventually concluded on what we now know as the Universal Docking System. The largest piece of hardware developed for ASTP was the docking module. The Apollo craft and Soyuz used different atmospheres. This meant that transferring crews directly between spacecraft was borderline impossible. The solution to this was using the docking module as an airlock. This also made the implementation of the Universal Docking System require less redesign on the Apollo side. Another problem that both sides encountered was a language barrier. Communication between mission controls was done using translators, but the astronauts and cosmonauts had to learn each other's languages, with communication between them done in the receiver's native language. Joint training was conducted in both countries, with the three astronauts and two cosmonauts spending multiple years together. Apart from just training for the mission, they also spent time bonding and learning each other's cultures.
Как время летит.
3 hours after docking occurred, the last hatch opened, with the cosmonauts and astronauts shaking hands in space. This event was viewed on live TV by millions of people around the world, a climax to all of the diplomacy and cooperation that led to this point. While on orbit, the astronauts conducted scientific experiments. The ultraviolet atmospheric absorption experiment and artificial solar eclipse both required the crafts to undock and redock. Both crews also exchanged numerous gifts with each other, including borscht, tree seeds, two halves of a plaque, and a portrait of Tom Stafford that Alexei Leonov drew. On the third day, the Americans also played a Russian version of the song Hello, Darling, for the Soviet crew and mission control.
Gentlemen, let me call to express my very great admiration.
It's taken us many years to open this door to useful cooperation in space between our two countries. And I'm confident that the day is not far off when space missions made possible
by this first joint effort will be more or less commonplace.
And may I say, in signing off,
here's to a soft landing.
On July 21st, 1975, Soyuz landed back on Earth, with Apollo finishing up experiments and landing 3 days later. Follow-up meetings were held with both nations, but as the 70s turned into the 80s, tensions rose again, closing cooperation for the immediate future. It wouldn't be until 1995, when Space Shuttle Atlantis docked with the Mir space station, that representatives from both nations met in space. With knowledge from Apollo-Soyuz, 11 Shuttle Mir missions were conducted, as well as the eventual construction and continuous habitation of the International Space Station, an international project spanning 23 years and 15 different countries. ASTP relates to the NHD theme because debate and diplomacy were the foundation for this first joint mission.
Расцелую, как в стар бывало, даже обнять еще раз сильнее.